champion of the world, Lennox Lewis.
Articulate.
Lennox Lewis is on a mission.
Contemplative.
This guy, when you talk to him, he hangs on every word that you say.
A thinker.
Well, he's trying to scare me, but I can't be faded.
This was a fighter that the world was not used to.
Well, Lennox and I have been friends for about 20 years, and I've always been impressed with his stature, obviously his proficiency in the ring, but most of all his intellect and his tenderness, his tender side. I've always felt that we always kind of are attracted to the train wreck, and while Mike Tyson was getting all publicity, Lennox was knocking everybody out, including Holyfield and Tua and finally Mike Tyson as well.
At first, he was a little bit of a rebel. Used to get in fights.
I pretended I was Muhammad Ali. And it was like a game to me. It was like a game of tag. That's when I realized that I enjoyed boxing. I loved it.
Lennox is definitely more of an introvert than somebody who's gregarious and outgoing and outlandish a little bit like Mike Tyson. But part of it is also that the heavyweight championship is largely seen as an American institution. And so the part of the reason that he didn't get as much accolade as he deserved based on his performance was that he was from Britain and Canada. And so he was kind of perceived as an outsider. He was kind of perceived as, like a Bond villain, if you will, somebody that an American needed to take down, as opposed to somebody who could achieve greatness in their own right.
Having escaped the nightmare of his childhood, Lennox Lewis was capable of brushing aside any setback.
Lennox had something to prove.
Lennox Lewis, I'm coming for you. I'm the best ever.
But it was about more than just redemption.
One of the things that always inspired me about boxing is it's very existential. It's win or lose. There's no coming in second. There's no blaming it on a teammate. There's no having a headache. You go in the ring and you're either victorious or you're a bum. And you don't get many chances of losing either. You usually won. And so if you're on the road to the top to become a world champion, you're on your own. And so that's one of the few sports where you're not given a second chance. And so it's kind of existential, and it always attracted me to the sport.
In life, nothing is really given to you. You have to earn it.
Lennox Lewis, the undisputed greatest.